Hi everyone, welcome to video number 6 on our Making the Most of Your Mac video series. This video will demonstrate how to access DFU mode, or Device Firmware Update mode, on Intel MacBooks with Apple's T2 security chip. In very rare circumstances, such as a power failure during a macOS upgrade or update, your Mac may become unresponsive. In this case, the firmware must be revived or restored. Note, you will need a second Mac in order to perform this process with the Apple Configurator 2 app installed on it. This can be downloaded for free from the App Store. By placing your own device into macOS DFU mode and by using Apple Configurator 2, on a supporting Mac, we can gain access to a variety of tools available for refreshing or updating the firmware on your failed device, as well as perform a complete restore of the failed device's firmware and operating system. The next steps in this video will guide you how to put your own device into macOS DFU mode in order to access it from Apple Configurator 2 on a supporting Mac. This process works well with all recent versions of macOS, including Big Sur and Monterey. Step 1. Download and install Apple Configurator 2 app on the supporting Mac. On the secondary supporting Mac, that will be supporting your own failed Mac, download and install the Apple Configurator 2 app available on the App Store. The link to the app can be found here in the video description below. Step 2. Disconnect external devices from both Macs. The necessary keyboard sequence in Step 7 needs to be followed precisely, and by disconnecting all external devices, you will allow for only the necessary input signals to be sent to your own Mac at startup. Disconnect all external devices except for the keyboard, the mouse, display, Ethernet cable, if attached, and the connection to AC power. Step 3. Ensure both Macs are on a level surface, stable, with good ventilation. You will want to make sure that nothing is obscuring the airflow to the devices for the purposes of ruling out environmental error. Ensure your devices are on a flat and stable surface, free from obstructions and vibration. Step 4. Turn on your secondary supporting Mac. Turn on your secondary supporting Mac the usual way by pressing the power button. Log in to the supporting Mac and wait for macOS to load. When the supporting Mac is awaiting input, open Apple Configurator 2 and wait for the app to load. Step 5. Plug a cable into the left front Thunderbolt port on your own Mac. This process only works when the USB-C cable is plugged into the front left USB-C port on your MacBook. Step 6. Plug the opposite end into the supporting Mac. Plug the opposite end of the USB-C cable into the supporting Mac. If using an older Mac without USB-C or Thunderbolt ports, a USB-C 2 port will work as well. Step 7. On your own Mac, press and hold the power button immediately, followed by right shift plus left option plus left control. Immediately following the pressing and holding down of the power button, approximately within half a second, all at once press all three of the following keys for about 10 seconds, or until you see DFU displayed in Apple Configurator 2 on the supporting Mac. The only indication that you've succeeded in putting your own Mac into DFU mode will be on the supporting Mac screen in Apple Configurator 2. You will see the initials DFU for Device Firmware Update. Step 8. This procedure takes a few tries to get right, so don't give up. If you don't see anything happening on the supporting Mac, release all keys on the keypad of your own Mac, and hold the power button for at least 10 seconds. Once you are sure your own Mac is powered off, attempt step 7 again. This may take 4, 5, 10 tries, but eventually you will see, as long as your cabling is correct, DFU mode enabled on the supporting Mac. Another note to make, it is also sometimes hard to know if your own Mac is actually on or off before attempting step 7 again. A good indicator will be pressing the caps locks button. If the screen is black and the device is actually powered on, you will see the caps lock button light up green when you press it. Don't forget to check out the other videos in this series. To keep it short, there is too much information to miss by not checking out the other videos in this series. Please give us a thumbs up and leave your comment below.